Mr. Robot Buddy is back. Welcome back to the Talos Principle. We're going to go in for some more puzzle magic today. We're going to try and clear this section as well, see how far we can get. Friendly crossfire. Alrighty. What do we got to do? Got 1, 2, 3 gun turrets. That's not good. And a bomb. Maybe we can use the bomb to blow one of them up. And there's a bomb behind there, too. Let's try letting that one out first. See if that does anything to help us. Nice. Yeah, it does. Okay. The box there. Both that gun's looking at. So if I disable that gun. And then go take that box. Oh, and then we can blow it up with the thing. I like it. I like it a lot. So move the box. Just reactivate that gun so the other dude's going to blow it up. I want to have a little look down there, actually. See if there's anything down there. Because it seems weird that you wouldn't access all of the map. So we'll put this in sight. Then we'll just keep moving. Let's see. Have we got anything? Oh, we got a star. I'll have that. Thank you very much. Okay, so now we need to take this and jam the final gun. Because we don't have any more bombs. Then we can use the box on the pressure band. Ta-da! Hey, I am on the ball with this now. I've got these puzzles down. Okay, next puzzle, everyone. What's this going to be called? Going over the fence. It's giving us clues already. Which is always helpful. So what have we got around us? We have that on top of a box over there. And we need to get it to there. So maybe if we just duplicate that but this side. Take the connector over. Put you out of the way. Grab the box. Because it seems weird that this fence is low as well. So just try that, see if that works. We can link you, then you. Put it there. Oh, would you look at that? Perfection. Tell you what, I hope these puzzles get harder because this is actually getting pretty easy now. That humble brag though, right? You know you mustn't cross... Yes, I know I mustn't cross the streams. We covered that in the last episode. Okay, so that guy's there. What else we got around? We got orange. We got... blue. Not much else around here. We got these two guys. Okay. So we need to get... orange to link there like that, and then we got blue to link there. How are we gonna do that? Because thingy in the way. Right, we have to do some fiddling. Let's try it this way. If I do. Do that like that. Oh, that's not going to do it because the beams are going to cross again. Oh, yeah, we use the box. There we go. So we do that, and then that, and that. There we go. So I was overthinking it again. But that's another piece down. We're doing really well for ourselves now. And we have one more puzzle section to complete here, and then we're ready to move on to the next area. One little buzzer. What's a buzzer? Or like a zzz or a... I don't know. So we have this, and that, and that. There we go. Easy, right? Oh, you disrupt beams. You're going to play that game with me, are you? Well, I'm going to put a box in the way. Now what are you going to do? There we go. That was easy. Okay, so that's that area done. We've got two sections that we can totally complete now. And by the looks of it, that's all the puzzles. Oh, have you got something to tell me? What is it? We've received the reply to our latest user support ticket. Display the reply. Okay. Account certification error, basic account. Account certification program diagnostic has been performed and no errors were reported. Have you completed the standard troubleshooting thing? If we delete our account, then we'll make a new one. Okay, so we delete that account, and then if we create a new one, we can try the puzzle again and try and get it better this time. In order to prevent unauthorized access to admin controls, only persons may sign up to new admin's account. The system will now conduct error. User has no registered account, but certification data already exists. Would you like to undertake the process again? Haha, yeah, see, that's what we want to do. Yes. Your issues with denial will be appended to your user profile. Further attempts to overwrite certification results will be logged. You will receive a notification if your attention is required. That's cheeky. Also, they sussed us out. They knew what we were trying to do. That's terrible. But once again, have a read of these. I'll pause it so you guys can read it as well, but I'm not going to be reading it out this time. Because there's a whole lot of crazy words going on, and you don't want to hear me reading this shit. So there you go. Another Athena text for us to read. Last but not least, the citizenship. So a lot more information about AIs and their worth and whether they're deemed on the same level as humans. So I reckon, I've got a theory, and I'm going to throw this one at early. I think that humanity has faced some sort of crisis, some sort of crazy apocalyptic scenario, and everything that is us has been uploaded into this program that those developer guys are working on. And we are now machines, in essence. And the only way humanity now exists is in the form of AI constructs, like me. That's what I think's going on. And I think that this whole program is a way to see that the AI technology has worked. Because in one of the previous episodes, you'll notice, it said it had been running for like hundreds of years. So I think there's something going on there. Okay. But that's enough of me rambling. That's my theory. You can hold me to that one, and we'll see how close I am when we come to it. But let's get into room 6. Oh, and our little buddy wants to talk to us again.
Long ago, I shaped these lands according to the purpose of the hidden words.
Okay.
Thus, all things have meaning, where before was only chaos. Know that, and have faith.
What is the hidden word? Why have we not been told about this? Let's read these. Actually, I'm gonna read some of these, actually, because some of these look quite funny. Ever since you moved to the new site, I feel funny. Not in a that way. Just, I feel like I'm about to start laughing at random. Probably shock, right? An inability to deal with reality. Or maybe it's just that we're working on this in this insane place with this insane technology, this insane project, so I feel like a genuine mad scientist. Stand aside, mortals. We will create life by the power of science. I mentioned this to Alex, and she got me a pair of fake glasses. Can't be a mad scientist without glasses, she said. Even Ian Malcolm had glasses. And I pointed at Elle and said, life, finds a way. Maybe you had to be there. Okay, so that's another reference back to the whole Jurassic Park thing. Chatbots. Chatbots are becoming increasingly sophisticated. True, but hardly relevant to this discussion. Are you sure? How do you know that I'm not a bot? Don't be ridiculous. I'm not ridiculous. Honestly, how would you know? Haha, troll. I'm not a troll. Yeah, right. Is there anything I've written so far that could not be written by a bot? I responded to simple insults like ridiculous and troll with very basic negation. And I detected that none of you use proper orthography, so I also avoided capitalization. What's the capital of France? Paris. Even the simplest script can pull that info off from it. What's the capital of Croatia? Zagreb. Okay, she's a bot. Lol. I'm not a bot. I'm European. We learn these things in school. She does bring up a valid point. How are you to know, like, in a text-based situation, How are you to know what, whether it's real, whether it's an algorithm, or whether it's a program? Shall the industrious husbandman then plant trees, fruit of which he will never see? Shall not the great man found laws, institutions, and a republic? What does the procreation of children imply, and our care to continue our names, and our adoption, and our scrupulous exactness in pouring up will? Inscriptions on monuments and panegyrics, but that our thoughts run on purity. What do you imagine that so many and such great men of our republic who have sacrificed their lives for its good expected? Do you believe that they thought their names should not continue beyond their lives? None ever encountered death for their country, but under a firm persuasion of immortality. Themistocles might have lived at his ease, so might Epaminondas. There we go. Sorry, guys. And not look abroad. And among the ancients, for instance, so might I myself. Somehow or other, there clings to our minds a certain presage of future ages. This both exists most firmly and appears most clearly in men of the loftiest genius, greatest souls. Take away this, and who would be so mad as to spend his life amidst toil and danger? That's actually a really good point. No, we never do anything, really, unless there's any sort of potential that we could be remembered long after we're gone, or leave some mark on the world. Even something as basic as this YouTube channel. I've made this YouTube channel to share my experiences with you guys. At the same time, it kind of immortalizes this aspect of me. Just something to ponder. Anyways, back to the puzzles. Mobile minefield. Okay. Gonna dodge straight past you. Gonna dodge straight past you. Ooh, that's what I want. Take that. Need the keys. How are we gonna get the keys? We'll lock him in there. We'll lock him in there, then we can go over there. I think that's probably gonna be safe, because I wanna keep the mines away from me. Don't want them near me. Good boy. You stay in there. Oh, there we go. Keys. Open that. We'll take our little jammer through with us. Whoa. God, that was too close. Ah, he has a switch. Cool. Now he's turned off. I can grab the jammer. Go about my merry business. Turn you off because you were going to shoot me in the face. And collect another puzzle piece. Aw, yeah. Why is there beeping there? Beeping? Beeping? Must be up above us. Let's just continue. Is there a way around there, perhaps? There's a star in there. How the hell am I supposed to get in there? Have I got to take a box? Maybe it's part of this quest. Let's go in here and have a look. Deception. Okay, this is going to be an annoying one, isn't it? What have we got to use? We've got you. Okay, I can work with this. We got an orange. Then we got to link it to an orange. I'll put you up here. Oop. Try that again without being shit. Right there, like that. Anything in here of you? Sorry, we've got another pedestal up there. Another orange thing there. Any more pedestals for us? That's where the puzzle piece is. Oh, it's up here. I'm such an idiot. We can then take the power from you to open you. Like that. Right. Okay. Cool. We can take you. That's orange. Okay. Right, you, for you. Alright, cool. Oh, we've got another one. Cool. Alright then. Now we got blues. So can I link you and you? Oh, cool. So now that that's linked, do I need that open? I do, because I need to have this power running, don't I?
Day three.
Okay, let's give this another attempt. I think I've got a rough idea on what I need to do. Kind of winging it still, but we'll see what happens. So we've got this one here. Need to link it to... Oh. Get it from you. Over to you. And that... That opens. We can then go up here. We can take this little guy. Link you like that. Like that. Open this door. Then we take this one. And we go that. Like that. Oh, that's not it. Take that one. That. That. Open this one. That gives us access to all three. Don't actually need to go around there, I don't think. I think that was wasting my time actually bothering to go around there. What I'm thinking we actually need to do is just make sure this way stays open. So I can link you to that like that. Put you here. Like that, like that. There we go. Move out of the way like so. Do that, and then we can link you like this. One there. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. We got there in the end. Well, I think this is as good a point as any to stop this one. So, thank you very much for joining me in this episode, guys. Really appreciate you sticking around. Hopefully, I'll see you again in the next episode that I make. See you, guys.